that.
Sure, that's a very important question and a very important point. Each pound of extra body weight has got 5/7 of a mile of capillary circulation extra, meaning if a person is 7 pounds extra weight, he has got 5 miles of capillary circulation extra, unnecessary in his body because that weight is extra. Now with each beat of the heart, 5 miles of blood will have to circulate extra, and so much more pressure upon the heart. And 72 beats per minute, roughly a lakh of beats per day, the blood has to be pumped 5 miles extra. And over a period of years, the amount of pressure upon the heart which was required becomes enormous. This extra weight can be brought down by walking. So we are coming to walking now. If we walked roughly at a slow pace on a plane surface, if we walked 1 hour, then you have consumed 200 calories. If you walked, say, roughly 10 hours a day, 10 hours a week, then you have walked 2,000, you have finished 2,000 calories. Walking 10 hours a week, you consume 2,000 calories in a week. Now to walk 2 hours, let us say 10 hours a week. If you want to walk 10 hours a week, you should walk 40 minutes in the morning and 40 minutes in the evening. But walk on a plain surface and walk with your normal pace. Don't walk fast. Well, if you walk fast, you won't be able to walk 40 minutes and you get tired and then you get fatigued. But you walk at your own pace, begin modestly, begin by walking 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the evening, and every week increase 2 minutes from 15 to 17 to 17 to 20. Like that, at the end of 3-4 months, you have reached roughly 40 minutes morning and evening, that is more than enough. Now, when you walk 10 hours a week, you are completing 2,000 calories in a week. But when you walk 3,500 calories, that means roughly 2 weeks and little more, then you have finished 1 pound of fat. 1 pound of fat will give us 3,500 calories. And 1 kilogram of body weight gives us roughly 7,000 calories. So completing, to use 1 kilo, we need to exhaust 3,500 calories. So let us say, if you walked for 4 to 6 weeks, 40 minutes in the morning and 40 minutes in the evening, you have burnt out 1 kilo of your body weight. Walk slowly, walk on a plain surface. Now slowly, if you did this, and let us say you in about roughly 3 months time, you have 1.5 kilos of weight, you're gone. In roughly 2 or 3 years time, you would have reduced your weight by anything from 6 to 8 kilos. That is quite enough, and that much sort of bring it with the weight down. Weight was one thing. Now the low density cholesterol we talked about. Cholesterol as a substance is like wax. It is not soluble in water, but we need it. Human body has 100 trillion cells totally. Each cell has a cell wall. And cholesterol is required to manufacture, to produce that cell wall. So we need cholesterol very badly. Without cholesterol, we can't survive. Cholesterol is produced in our liver. Whether you are a vegetarian, whether you are a non-vegetarian, whether you eat a drop of ghee or you don't, cholesterol will be manufactured in your liver. And cholesterol will be roughly responsible, 85% of cholesterol that we need is manufactured in our liver. This cholesterol, which is manufactured in the liver, stays in the liver cell because it is not soluble in water. It's like wax. So that body manufactures a compound called lipoprotein, which makes that cholesterol soluble. There is a lipoprotein which will take from the liver 2 different parts of our body cells, This cholesterol is known as low density lipoprotein. Low density lipoprotein will carry from the liver to all parts of the body, including the arteries taking blood to the heart. Low density lipoprotein is constantly carrying this cholesterol there, because there every cell is going to need cholesterol for manufacture. And there are many other functions cholesterol does. For example, the male hormone testosterone, the female hormone, they are all produced by cholesterol. Cortisol, a very important hormone in the body, manufactured by cholesterol. Vitamin D is manufactured by cholesterol. So cholesterol is very important. But even good things in excess are bad. And what happens is, if the low density lipoprotein is being manufactured more and more by the liver, more and more blood will occur in the, more and blood will be, cholesterol will be taken to tissues, and the arteries inside will have excess deposition of cholesterol, and the arteries will become narrow. The second cholesterol, called the high density lipoprotein, takes away from the cell to the liver. So that is good, because it takes away the deposit of cholesterol in the artery back into the liver. And from the liver, all the cholesterol which is brought to the liver, the cholesterol is excreted into our bile. And from the bile, from it goes into the intestine. And ordinarily, a part of it is reabsorbed and goes back into the liver. And that's how the cholesterol is conserved. Now, women, when they are pregnant, a baby is born from one cell, 100 million cells in 9 months, the amount of cholesterol needed for that baby is enormous. So the cholesterol in a woman who is pregnant keeps on rising. That entire cholesterol is brought back to normal after the delivery. But supposing there is a woman who has repeated many children. It was customary in India to say Ashtaputra Sobhagyavati Bhava. So you gave a kind of thing to the woman that she should have 8 children, 8 sons, frankly. So, if a person, woman has 8 deliveries, imagine that with each child doing the amount of cholesterol she will have, and a woman who has multiparous, who has many children, will have each time cholesterol rising and coming down, all that cholesterol will go into the gallbladder and she gets gallstones. Gallstones occur in women who have multiple pregnancies. Now, there is an article in our diet which is, current science has shown that it is very, many articles in our food can be rich, that is a gum. Gum is, in colloquial language called dink. Now, this gum was first detected, invented in America, in the seeds of gawar. So it was named by the Americans as the gawar gum. Now it was also then subsequently found that it is present in the bees of practically all vegetables. Gawar, parasbhi, gosari, dhodki, kalri, bhindi, all of them will have gawar gum. And the gum that normally is consumed is gum acacia, that is the Bahul's gum, which is used to prepare the gum laddu. Now, pregnant women during pregnancy and delivery were advised to eat that so that their cholesterol will come down. How? When you eat take gum, in whichever form, either in the vegetable or as gawar gum, this gum will go inside. And as it starts going into it is a fiber, it is a soluble fiber. No fiber is absorbed, it is going down slowly down below. Then it catches hold of these cholesterol molecules and takes it down with it. So then the cholesterol in the blood will become low and low and low. And someone who wishes to reduce his cholesterol should use gawar gum, that is this, or for that matter, this gum acacia, which is used to paste anything that we normally use. It has no taste, it has no color. You can just put it in water and put that into everything that you eat, and your cholesterol will come down because it takes the whole thing down and won't allow it to be absorbed. This gum also has an extremely important function in digestion. Gum goes down into the intestine, and when it reaches the large intestine has innumerable bacteria. I mean, not possible for me to tell you how many trillion bacteria there may be. It is believed that the bacteria inside our body are anything from 6 to 8 times the cells that human body has. And therefore, these bacteria which are there in the large intestine, these bacteria break down this gum. And it produces a substance called short chain fatty acid. I will talk about the fatty acid chain. These short chain fatty acids are extremely rich source of energy to the lining of the large intestine. And the large intestine has functions to perform. The most important functions, large intestine functions, are three. Whenever we eat food and we digest food, the digested food may have important things like vitamins and minerals and amino acids and glucose and fatty acids, they are all absorbed. The thing which the body does not want is like a water liquid material is given down to the large intestine. For 24 hours it is seeping inside. 1500 milliliters of liquid stool is delivered to the large intestine in 24 hours. 24 hours it is going on inside. 1500 milliliters of liquid stool is converted into 500 grams of solid stool by absorbing 1000 cc of water. To absorb it needs energy. This energy comes from short chain fatty acids. That's function number one. Function number two is whether it is delivered to the right lower end. From there the whole stool has to go gradually, slowly and slowly, and go to the left lower part of the intestine and stored there for 12 hours, 14 hours, 24 hours, and kept there. So for transit of the semi-solid solid material and continuously absorbing water from there, you need energy. That energy comes from short chain fatty acids. Lastly, whatever stool that has come there must be thrown out as one mass at one time in the morning. That entire evacuation should not take more than a few minutes. That energy is required. All these three functions are done by large intestine, and for that the energy is short chain fatty acid which comes from gums. And therefore taking gum occasion is ideal. But even in our country we can get gawar gum and vegetables with gum, any amount fresh. So we don't have to look at that. But today, in the treatment of every diabetic, gawar gum is advised as a form of treatment. Tons of gawar is exported to America, and they convert from those seeds to gawar gum, and they send it back to us in the form of gawar gum and sell it for a price which is anything from 1,000 to 5,000 times the cost of gawar. But we say we are repeating what happened with East India Company and the Britishers when they came and they took away all the cotton from us and sent back the cloth. So what we need to do is to take that gum so that the whole cholesterol will come down. HDL cholesterol will take away the cholesterol from the tissue to the liver, it's a good cholesterol. And you will increase the level of HDL cholesterol by what is called as a dynamic exercise. A dynamic exercise is a kind of exercise which increases your pulse rate. Like swimming, like running, like walking fast, like doing any kind of exercise which will make bodily movements fast. And you do that from anything from 25 to 30 minutes at a time. Minimum 3 times a week, preferably 5 times a week. If you did it 7 times a week, so much the better, but that's not necessary. Even if a person were to do it 5 times a week, it's quite enough. Minimum 3 times a week. What sort of exercise? You do treadmill, or you run, or you walk fast, and you increase your pulse rate. There is a formula. This formula has been derived by a scientist by working on a very large number of people. The formula is very simple. 220 minus your age, whatever figure you get, two-thirds of that, that should be your pulse rate when you do a dynamic exercise. You do these exercises for 25 to 30 minutes, three times a week. Then, what this sort of an exercise will do is, it does many good things. It improves the function of the heart, it improves the function of the leg. Well, these are called as cardiorespiratory exercises. Then it increases the HTA, which is very, very good. There is no other way of increasing the HTA. The only way is to increase by this dynamic exercise. Now, when you do dynamic exercise for 30 minutes, then blood supply to the brain, to the kidney, to the liver, to the skin, and to every other part of the body, mainly to the brain, increases by 180% for the next 18 hours. So supposing there is a boy who wants to appear for an exam or go for an interview or do whatever is required. All these activities are brain related. And what is important is that the brain must be supplied with enough blood. And the person were to do a 30 minutes exercise in the morning, then the next 18 hours, by the time he sleeps again, his blood supply to the brain will increase by 180%, which is a very good thing. No drug is known, no yogic posture is known, Shirshasana does not do it, let me make it very clear, increasing the blood supply to the brain. The only thing which is known to increase blood supply to the brain is a dynamic exercise for 30 minutes. And it will also increase high density cholesterol and to do everything other thing. It also helps the cardiorespiratory system in many ways, like while you are walking. So when you are walking, when you do any muscle activity, let us say I move the hand. When I move the hand, there is one portion of the body, the muscle will contract. Whatever blood that is there in that muscle will be squeezed out of the muscle and it goes into the veins and goes to the heart. And when we walk, we are contracting muscles of the foot and of the calf and of the thigh and of the hip and the back on one side and the shoulder, so that one side of the body's muscles are contracting and relaxing with each step. When you take one step further, 75 milliliters of blood go back to the heart. You put another step, another 75 cc's of blood go back to the heart. Heart has two chambers, the right chamber and the left chamber. And when a heart contracts, from each chamber, exactly 75 milliliters of blood goes to the body. So when you are walking, there are two pumps. One pump of the heart, which is taking going blood to the limbs, and the other pump in the limbs, like leg, which is taking the blood to the heart. So it takes away 50% of the load of the heart straight. It is a wrong idea that to lie down, you give rest to the heart. You require to lie down and take rest only during the acute phase. Once the acute phase is over and the doctors do mobilization and start, slowly and slowly you must walk and increase your activity and apply that formula. 220 minus age, it's a very simple thing. Supposing somebody's age is 70 years, then 220 minus 70 will be 150. Two-thirds of that is 100. So you will say, a man of 70 years of age, if he were to bring his pulse rate to roughly 100 per minute from the 72 which is normal, then he has done enough exercise. Younger you are, more awareness you need to do. Even if you are older than 70, then less and less and less, and after a certain age, you need not do any exercise of this nature. Once or twice a week is quite adequate, that keeps you quite all right, keeps you quite fit. So that's about LDL, that's about HDL, that's about walking, that's about prevention of heart disease.